This lecture is about marine aquaculture, the fastest growing food sector in the world. You will learn in this lecture that eating a tuna is actually like eating a wolf eater if it was an equivalent food chain on land. You will learn that most of the aquaculture production currently is not sustainable and that we are partly actually taking protein away from the human population. It's badly needed. And finally, you will learn that saving or protecting the fish stocks is best done by managing the fish stocks and not by replacing wild-caught fish by aquaculture fish. So let us first look at the global production of food from the sea. Clearly see is that around the 1990s, the wild capture fisheries leveled off at a level of about 95 million metric tons per year, very much in contrast to the dark blue, which shows the almost exponential rise of the aquaculture food production from waters in general. So at a first glance, we may think, okay, so aquaculture alleviates the pressure from the wild fish stocks that cannot yield more catch to human nutrition. Let us dissect now more what this dark blue sector is, the aquaculture production. And here we quickly see that aquaculture is actually a lot of freshwater fish. So 60% or something are cyprinids that are mainly grown in East Asia. Then we have a large section of crustaceans like shrimp and bivalves such as oysters. And the fraction of fish is actually quite small. So actually here the production of seafood in terms of harvestable fish that could alleviate the pressure on fish population looks quite limited already. We also need to have a look at how the aquaculture is organized. Evidently recirculating systems based on land need huge infrastructure and have a very high energy demand. So in terms of their carbon footprint, they're hardly sustainable. At a medium level, we have, for example, net pens for sea bass or for salmon. And at the lowest level, we would have, in a way, passive rope cultures of mussels and algae that need no additional feeding. This is very important to keep in mind if we look at the general overall sustainability of an aquaculture setting. What's now the general problem with having marine fish in an aquaculture setting? We need to be aware of that the food chains in the ocean are much longer than on land. So whereas on land we have the cows as the first consumers of primary productivity, in the oceans these would be tiny crustaceans and they are simply not suited for human nutrition. Conversely, if we eat a mackerel, the corresponding trophic level on land would already be the eater of a wolf eater. So that's evidently a fantasy animal which doesn't exist on land, but it very well exists in the form of large pelagic predators in the oceans. So in other words, if we want to keep sea bass or sea bream or raised tuna, we have to feed them with other fish. These other fish are called forage fish. So those are mainly small pelagics which are caught at a rate of about 20 million tons per year. So let's have a look at the budget. So 18 million metric tons are then converted into, they are basically dried, are converted into 6 million metric tons of fish oil and fish meal. And they then go to livestock feed on land, about half of it. And another fraction goes to aquaculture. We ignore here now the freshwater portion. And then we see that about 2.1 million of those forage fish-derived feed goes into producing fish in marine aquaculture. And if you remember now, we have about 2.5 million tons production of marine fish in the aquaculture. You see that we have a one-to-one relationship, which is actually worse because we have dried fish oil and dried fish meal. So at the moment, actually, we lose protein that could be available for human nutrition in poorer countries when we feed those small forage fish to larger marketable fishes such as sea bream or sea bass. So what could be solutions out of that sustainability dilemma? One solution is to replace the fish-derived protein by plant-derived protein, for example, from soybean or rapeseed. And this is happening. So there are really intense research projects trying to replace that. And there is now considerable progress has been made, but at the moment this progress is completely eaten up by the increase of aquaculture production. So the net demand on forage fish still increases and is not decreasing. Another solution is to use different fish species. So those fish species that are omnivorous, like tilapia or pangasius or carp, with those species it's possible to completely replace fish-derived protein by plant-derived protein. So in principle here the feeding problem is completely solved, and it's no surprise that these fishes now are heavily increasing on the market. But these are all freshwater fish, and we are talking here about health and sustainability of the oceans. What's now with the argument that marine aquaculture saves marine fish stocks? And here we can say a clear no. It's in fact inverse. So we have to have severely overfished fish stocks to make aquaculture profitable. As one example, I'm showing you here the recruitment of the European eel. Recruitment levels of small eels, so-called glass eels, arriving here are down to 1% of the original levels. And actually, eel is one of the few species listed in the red list, and it's still exploited by fisheries. You see in the second diagram the increase in the production of fattened eels. So they are not based on the complete life cycle, it's just that small eels are caught and fattened to then later be sold on the global food market. And this only became profitable when the catch of wild eel decreased dramatically. The same situation happened in cod. Here, fortunately, the Barents Sea cod stock recovered due to good management, and many of the cod aquaculture facilities that had been built up during the years when cod was in a very bad shape, they are now basically not working anymore because it's not worth to produce cod with the relatively expensive aquaculture settings. Another sustainability issue with aquaculture is that it needs space, and that it needs very, very pristine and very vulnerable space, in particular in coastal ecosystems, if we think, for example, of crustacean and here shrimp aquaculture. So this picture shows you a temporal comparison over 20 years how the mangrove forest in Honduras has been converted, but this I could show you similar pictures from other Asian countries. So Honduras is now not a particular bad example, but it's a very well worked out example from the Millennium Ecosystem Assessment. So why is this conversion a problem? This conversion is a problem because the very valuable mangrove forests are destroyed that are provide coast protection and at the same time collect sediments so as to help making the land raise in the face of sea level rise. So what could be a sustainable solution? A sustainable solution could be that we farm down the food web. So we should not fish down the food web, but we should farm down the food web, meaning that we should tackle lower trophic levels for our aquaculture. And these lower trophic levels could be filter feeders, like oysters or these mussels on rope culture, or it could even be algae, so primary producers. And common to both such types of aquaculture that's often then called mariculture is that they at the same time tackle an additional problem, which is nutrient pollution. So by not needing to feed them additionally, we do not have additional input of nutrients, which would be the case in fish or shrimp aquaculture, but we even can extract nutrients that then is incorporated in the biomass of mussels or algae. Another idea is to have small, self-contained, little enhanced ecosystems in multi-trophic agriculture. Mm. These systems are very much still in the experimental phase, so here science still has a lot to contribute. Basically, what we try is to have the primary producers and or the filter feeders together with the consumers. That's for sure something that could work, but at the moment it will not work at a price level that's competitive on the world market. So what are our take-home messages? I hope I could make clear that at the moment many aquaculture practices, in particular with marine fish, are not sustainable. We are taking away protein for human consumption, and we are not saving the fish stocks. To the contrary, such aquaculture for very high-priced fish is only profitable because the wild populations have been decimated. And to save fish stocks, we have to better manage fish stocks. Solutions to improve sustainability is farming down the food chain, go for mariculture, go for bivalves, or maybe even go for algae. And maybe also, now still in an experimental phase, go for multi-trophic aquaculture.